Hello guys, my name is Yash. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. In this video, we will learn about advanced swing components. Before you learn about advanced swing components, make sure you know about J component class and swing basic components. I have already created a video on it. Link is provided in description. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Also, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe so that you don't miss any updates. In addition to basic components, swing provides several advanced components. So let's see these components in detail. The J-tabbed pane class is used to switch between a group of components by clicking on a tab with a given title or icon. It inherits J-component class. These are the constructors of J-tabbed pane. In this example, we import a package and create a class. After that, we have created a main class constructor. Then we have created JFrame, JTextArea, JPanel and JTabbedPane. After that, we have set the bounds of JTabbedPane and added JTextArea to one of the JPanel. We have added all JPanels to JTabbedPane and then added JTabbedPane to JFrame. JPanel provides space in which an application can attach any other component. Difference between JFrame and JPanel is, JFrame is a heavyweight container used as the top level window, whereas JPanel is a lightweight container generally used to organize GUI components. JPanels are added on the top of JFrame, whereas GUI components are added on one or more JPanels. Swing provides JTree class to display the tree structured data or hierarchical data. At the top, JTree has root node which works as a parent for all nodes in the tree. These are the constructors of JTree class. In this example, we import two packages. After that, we create a class and inside its constructor, we have created a JFrame. After that, we use a default mutable tree node. A default mutable tree node is a general purpose node in tree data structure. Here, we have one main node. Inside main node, we have subnodes. We have added those nodes to JTree and then we add JTree on JFrame. Swing provides JTable class to display data in tabular form. It consists of rows and columns. These are the constructors of JTable class. In this example, we import a package. After that, we create a class and inside its constructor, we create a JFrame. Then we create two arrays and add those arrays to JTable. After that, we set the bounds of JTable and add JTable to JScrollPane. Then we have added JScrollPane to JFrame and set the size and visibility of JFrame. A progress bar is a widget which is used to display progress of a particular task. for example file download or transfer. Swing provides JProgressBar class to create a progress bar. It allows vertical or horizontal progress bar. These are the constructors of JProgressBar. In this example, we import two packages. After that, we create a class. Inside the main method, we have created a variable and the JFrame. After that, we have created JProgressBar and set the minimum and maximum value of JProgressBar. Here, setStringPainted method sets the value of StringPainted property, which determines whether the progress bar should render a progress string. Then we have set the layout and size of JFrame. After that, we have added JProgressBar on JFrame and set the visibility of JFrame. Here, we have created a for loop. In that loop, we have try-catch block. Thread.sleep method tells the current thread to sleep for some number of milliseconds, letting other processes run. After that, we have setString method that is used to set value to the progress string. Tooltips are small windows of text that pop up when the user leaves the mouse cursor over a component for a second or two. They are used to explain the functionality of the component. Creating a tooltip for any J component object is easy. Use the setTooltipText method to set up a tooltip for the component. These are the methods of tooltip. In this example, we import javax.swing package. Then we create a class. In the main method, we have created JFrame, JPassword field, and JLabel. We have used setTooltipText method to set tooltip on JPassword field component. Then we have set bounds of label and JPassword field. After that, we add components on JFrame and set the size, layout, and visibility of JFrame. Java provides JFileChooser class, which is used to display a dialog window from which user can select file. These are the constructors of JFileChooser. In this example, we import javax.swing package, then inside the main method, we have created a JFileChooser and we have set the title of JFileChooser. Here, we have showOpenDialog method. This method makes you choose pre-existing file, that is, browse to location and choose a file that is already there. You can still choose to delete or overwrite selected file. If you like this video, share it with your friends and also don't forget to like.